There's a lot of ancient writing that we know about, but just don't have. People go wild thinking about what could be hidden in the lost writings of, say, Aristotle. But writing is fragile, and texts can easily disappear. Not because of one specific library burning down, necessarily. Rather, texts have been lost, damaged, or even intentionally destroyed by people who wanted to reuse their materials. But sometimes a text is not quite as lost as it seems. Modern technology offers us some amazing ways to recover writing that seemed like it was lost for good in those damaged and reused pages. It's as if we've just started finding the keys to a bunch of centuries-old time capsules. And now, historians can start recreating a library of texts that give us a fascinating look into the past, at some of the foundations of our modern world. In 1947, some Bedouin shepherds wandered into a cave on the northwest shore of the Dead Sea, looking for a lost goat. Instead, they found 11 ancient jars, and one of them held 3 long-lost scrolls. Once word got out, archaeologists rushed to the scene and spent the next 9 years scouring nearby caves, where they dug up thousands of pieces of falling-apart scrolls. Carbon dating revealed that they were 2,000 years old. The scrolls were in rough shape. Many were just lying on the floor, getting ruined by water and the elements. Others had gotten buried in bat poop or partly turned to liquid. But amazingly, some of these ancient texts were salvageable, with the help of science. The key to decoding these scrolls actually came from a NASA scientist whose lab used a technique called multispectral imaging as a way to explore planets. Multispectral imaging involves capturing the same photograph multiple times, but at different wavelengths. Normally, when you take a picture with a regular camera, you're capturing the full range of visible light, from violet to red. But when you take a picture using multispectral imaging, you only capture one narrow range of light at a time. So one image might just capture violet light, while another only detects red light. You can also capture wavelengths that aren't visible to our eyes, like ultraviolet and infrared. The key is, different objects reflect different wavelengths of light depending on what they're made of. So once you see what wavelengths an object is reflecting, you can often figure out what it's made of. NASA scientists use this technique to figure out what types of surfaces are reflecting light into their cameras, and one of them realized this technique might just be the key to decoding damaged documents as well. See, when you're dealing with an old, damaged text, it can be hard or impossible to read the faded words, especially if the surface is stained. But even if the text is faded, it may reflect some light at certain wavelengths where parchment does not. So multispectral imaging can help improve the contrast between the text and the surface it's on. It can also help where there are stains covering the ink. To your eye, it might be impossible to make out a letter against a brown stain because your eye is seeing the full spectrum of wavelengths at once. But if you have a camera image specific wavelengths at a time, the ink may stand out in some of those photos. And scientists did this with some fragments of the Dead Sea Scrolls, and suddenly, invisible words came into focus. They were written in various languages, including Hebrew, Greek, and Aramaic. In case you haven't guessed it, these Dead Sea Scrolls turned out to be the oldest biblical manuscripts still in existence. They were over 1,000 years older than the oldest known copies of the Hebrew Bible, aka the Old Testament. Reviving these texts has kept scholars busy for decades. They're still at work filling in the details of the region's history and exploring how the ancient religious traditions captured in these texts grew into world religions like Judaism and Christianity. A little bit further west, around the same time that scribes in the Levant were writing out these scrolls, ancient Greek scientists and philosophers were writing out all sorts of treatises on the natural world. Time has done away with many of those too, but now and then we get lucky. In 1906, an interesting old prayer book turned up in a library in what's now Istanbul. It was full of Christian prayers written in Greek in the 13th century. But the interesting part was a shadowy text underneath all that. Back in the day, old works written on parchment were often erased and written over, because parchment was sometimes more valuable than what was written on it, at least in the opinion of the scribe at the time. That produced manuscripts with multiple layers of text written over each other, called palimpsests. In this book, the second faded layer of text hidden under the lines of prayer was also written in Greek, mixed with symbols and math. It wasn't all legible, but a Danish scholar managed to piece together some of the text and figured out that he was looking at copies of 7 treatises written by Archimedes. Archimedes was a legendary Greek mathematician who lived in the 3rd century BCE. He's known for discovering pi and the foundations of calculus. He also supposedly invented a screw pump to lift water against gravity. Unfortunately, a lot of his work has been lost in the over 2 millennia between then and now, but the work that has survived can give us a look at what amazing science was happening during his time. And 2 of the 7 treatises uncovered in this prayer book were completely unknown. So this was a really exciting discovery, except just 2 years after this palimpsest was discovered, the book vanished. It was gone for almost a century, until it resurfaced at a New York auction in 1998. The guy who eventually shelled out $2 million for it then lent the book to a museum. It was now in even worse condition. Pages were missing and mold was covering some of the surviving pages. But scientists could now examine it with modern technology and piece together more of the text. As with the Dead Sea Scrolls, they started off with multispectral imaging. This can be a good tool for uncovering the faint undertext in palimpsests because it can bring out the contrast between the text and the parchment. But that's not always the case. These copies of Archimedes' treatises were written by different people with different ink, and some inks just never popped out against the paper. Because if one ink responds to different wavelengths the same way as the parchment, you're basically looking for a black cat at midnight. There's no contrast to set one apart from the other. And that's what happened with part of the Archimedes palimpsest. Scientists just couldn't see the text, so they went with a different approach. They tried to bring out the invisible text using ultraviolet fluorescence. Fluorescence is what happens when you shine a light on something and it glows in response. Certain materials do this in response to UV light, including parchment. It gives off a bluish glow, so when scientists put the manuscript under a UV light, the parts that were covered with ink, including the hidden text, stood out against this glow. That left scientists with an image that captured both the newer text and Archimedes' text. Now they were close. To get Archimedes' text alone, they subtracted a regular image showing just the newer text, and finally, they had the hidden text before them. It took a few more analytical tricks to make the text fully legible, but the manuscript's UV fluorescence was the key. But before we get to the next lost piece of writing, all science needs funding, so let's take a quick break. This SciShow video is supported by Jump, a statistical analysis software that makes powerful analytics quick and accessible. Like, financially accessible. The new Jump marketplace has tons of free features, like pre-made applications, add-ins, data connectors, and other Jump extensions. So not only can you customize the software to suit your needs for a great price, but you can do it without coding. And if you want to code, you can, with Jump's scripting to automate repeat analysis. Plus, the workflow builder, which lets you share processes with colleagues so that you can standardize best practices and boost reproducibility. Jump offers a 30-day free trial for anyone, anywhere. You can check it all out at jmp.com/scishow to see the benefits of visual statistics for yourself. Now, not every material fluoresces, and the ones that do fluoresce do so in different ways. Some glow in response to UV rays, others in response to X-rays, and the glow they give off is different too. This makes fluorescence a really useful trick for deciphering old texts. We just saw an example of fluorescence under a UV beam, but if you shine a beam of X-rays onto some parchment, you'll find that this time it's not the parchment that glows, but if you're lucky, the ink itself. And scientists use this trick to rescue one of the most intriguing lost texts they've ever come across. This one showed up in an old book bound in the 16th century. The book itself was nothing special, but on its back cover, some black paint had worn off. Underneath was a hidden text. It wasn't a total surprise, because bookbinders from this era often recycled materials from older books to bind new ones. On one hand, that was a pretty tragic decision from our point of view that led to the destruction of countless old texts. But on the other hand, it ended up preserving a bunch of texts that might have just fallen into oblivion otherwise. So today, we have a bunch of old books full of stowaways from even older times. This particular text was completely impossible to read with the naked eye, but this is where scientists turned to fluorescence again in an attempt to see through the paint. This time, they used what's known as macro X-ray fluorescence. Essentially, they used a scanner to shine an X-ray beam onto a surface. The ink fluoresced in response, months and ultimately revealed not just one text, but three. Each one had been written in a different kind of ink, with different metals in it. The most recent one was around the same age as the book itself, and had been written in cursive. It showed up thanks to the glow of iron that had been in this scribe's ink. Underneath that, the glow of mercury revealed another script from the 14th century that seemed to be written in red ink. And underneath that was the real prize. Traces of calcium revealed a text written in the 12th century that quoted a passage from an English scholar named Bede who lived in the 8th century. Bede was basically a walking encyclopedia. He wrote a ton about the history of England, he wrote scientific manuals, and he wrote interpretations of the Bible. We owe a lot of what we know about medieval England to Bede. The text buried in the back cover of this book was not unknown, but the discovery was still a big deal. It showed historians where his work was circulating and who might have been influenced by it. And that helps us understand how knowledge spread among people and places at different moments in time. Rescuing old texts like this can bring to life whole worlds that we'll never know. But some texts weren't just scraped off or sliced up to make way for new work. In Mesoamerica, conquistadors who arrived in the 16th century systematically burned all the indigenous works they could find. Today, there are just over a dozen known manuscripts remaining from pre-colonial times. One of those is the Codex Añute. It's a document produced by the Mixtec culture and comes from the area that's now Oaxaca. Unlike the manuscripts from Europe and the Middle East, this one is made up of colorful pictographs drawn on strips of leather. The leather was folded up like an accordion and covered with a chalk mixture to create stiff white pages. In the 1950s, one researcher was studying this document when he noticed what looked like hidden images peeking out through cracks in the surface. As far as he could tell, it looked like he had a palimpsest on his hands. But it wasn't until decades later that scientists had any luck viewing those images. This palimpsest was especially tricky because the paints used on this document were organic. They didn't contain metals like the other inks we've seen. That made all those tricks for detecting traces of metals completely useless here. But in a study published in 2016, researchers revisited this document using a technique known as hyperspectral imaging. This method is similar to multispectral imaging. With multispectral imaging, you're capturing images at a few different wavelengths. But with hyperspectral imaging, you capture hundreds of images from all the wavelengths across the whole range. You end up with a whole bunch of data, so it takes special software and some serious computer power to crunch through it all. It's not going to be the go-to method for every hidden text, but the benefit is that it brings out really nuanced color variations that are too subtle for us to pick out with our eyes, or even with regular multispectral imaging. In this case, researchers were able to uncover hidden pictographs representing an account of the ancestors of the codex's authors, going back for generations. Scientists haven't been able to fully interpret the pictographs yet, and there are some parts that they still need to uncover. But they hope that eventually they can use the recovered images to better understand the way of life of the people who made them, and the archaeological remains they left behind. Given how few of these codexes we have, getting two for the price of one is huge. Many of these technologies are new, or only recently being used to explore lost texts. But as researchers put them into practice, little by little, it's like they're opening an invisible door to a library full of ideas and history that's been there all along, just waiting to be unlocked.